Penny has a heart as big as a cabin. I mean, it's just, it is huge.
I didn't know I had a business brain. In fact, I'm not so sure whether I still have a business brain. I'm still working that out.
Behind the glitz, the glam, and the energy, there is a salt of the earth person.
She's a spin doctor extraordinaire, and she commands the attention and respect of A-listers the world over. Penny Stein is one of the very few people in the country who has a direct line to some of the biggest names in entertainment and beyond. Think Celine Dion, Lionel Richie, Sir Elton John, just to name a few. When she started her company 26 years ago, she sold her wardrobe for capital. And from the mere 1,800 rand she'd made, 75 went toward a used typewriter with missing keys. Armed with bare necessities, a will of steel, and a hunger to succeed, she became one of the most revered and respected women in the business. Like you, I'm curious, what sets Penny Stein apart from the rest?
You got into the record business early on. How did that happen for you?
I went for an interview. There were three interviews happening. One was for a PR in a hotel, one was a PR in a record company, and one was a PR in, I can't remember the third, but there were three. Anyway, I went to all three, and the last one happened to be RPM Record Company. First interview ever, I felt like they spun me through a washing machine, but I seemed to pull through it, and they offered me the job there and then and said, can you start tomorrow? I spent 8 years with them. I had an extraordinary career. And I'd been in the record company and I kind of got to the limit of really where I could go. I didn't know I had a business brain. In fact, I'm not so sure whether I still have a business brain. I'm still working that out. But I figured that if you brought all this work into one place, then you could work for all these people and you could get lots of experience.
And that's how Penny Stein
And that's birthed. How it started. And within sort of 6 months, like the work was flying in. And it was, how am I going to cope with this now? You know, now you put it out there, how am I going to cope? So I got staff in, and then the concerts started coming in. I mean, my very first concert was a big one on my own, not as part of a team, was the Rolling Stones at Ellis Park.
You and had your first major gig.
Yeah, that my first was Rolling
with
Stones.
With the Rolling Stones.
Yes, that
Excuse
was my
me?
First.
Yeah, it was. How did that go down? How did you pull that off?
It was a bomb. It was just unbelievable.
With more than 50 major concerts under her belt and a very impressive list of accomplishments, in the 26 years she's been in business, nothing wins her much praise like her ability to connect with people from all walks of life.
Penny is iconic in this industry. There are always leaders and followers, but Penny Stein is associated with razzmatazz, with famous people, with not so famous people.
I go back to like 1980. We're in 2013.
Yeah.
It's a lot. Sort of from Prodigy to Pavarotti and everything in between. And you gotta know how to just fit in.
Okay.
Go with the flow. Mm. Be flexible. If it doesn't go your way,
adapt.
Adapt. Mm. Things always work out. And you know, people get into a bit of a panic.
Yeah.
She's not the kind of person who brings problems to the table. She's the kind of person who brings solutions to the table. And I mean, so many times we've been in a fix, either an interview is being canceled or the star is acting like a prima donna or whatever, you know, and we would all be thrown out, but Penny will come with a solution and it would work for all of us.
Penny is the real deal in PR. I mean, there are people in public relations who think that that's about sending out a press release or about trying to get marketing opportunities for a product or a company or an individual. And Penny knows that it's about relationships, which is why I'm happy to say nice things about her.
And I also think that not being starstruck has been one of my greatest assets.
How did you acquire that asset?
I don't think I acquired it. I think I always just saw it as my job.
Mm.
It was just my job. The only time I became like obsessed, but like a fan who needed a paramedic. I mean,
Tell me.
I'm telling you,
yeah.
I needed to phone the paramedics to help the screaming fan who was me.
Yeah, oh my gosh.
It was Lionel Richie.
Yeah.
And then he opened the show in Johannesburg and he said, you know what, I'm going to dedicate his song Penny Lover to you. And he went like that to me. That was so magical.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I mean, that for me was magical.
Mm.
Because that was the only time I was a fan.
I think Penny is exactly the same person, whether she's talking to Elton John or she's talking to a homeless guy. And she'll be the same effusive, intelligent, interesting, and funny person that she is. I mean, Luther Vandross pushed her into a pool once. Not a lot of people have a story like that. Penny's a very interesting person to sit down and talk to.
Penny has also been quite the ambassador for South Africa and has over the years been the go-to person for international stars who've met SA icon Nelson Mandela, an experience which she says helped to further normalize A-listers in her eyes.
Hey, listen, but you've also brought a lot of these stars to someone they were fans of, Nelson Mandela. Yeah. How was that relationship for you?
He loved meeting all of them, and he was so gracious and welcomed everybody and made an effort to find out who they were. But let me tell you about them when they met him. Okay, first of all, they used to ask me what they must say. I mean, imagine Tina Turner asking you, what must I say? Or like Celine Dion saying, what must I say? Imagine them saying, what must I wear? I mean, here I am telling the biggest divas with the largest wardrobes what to wear.
Yeah.
And what if he asks me this or asks me that? And I always say, you know what, just be yourself.
Yeah.
Take the star out of you and just be yourself. They would come in and they would be gaga. Okay, the dry mouth, the words wouldn't come out. Okay, and then the tears would come down. And then eventually he had, you know, this incredible way of just making you feel so comfortable. And, you know, then everyone would calm down and all the hyperventilation would stop. And they'd always have a picture.
From rubbing shoulders with the who's who's in the entertainment and other industries, she's now gone on to lend her unmatched skill and support to charity causes by aligning with the Dis-Chem Foundation, which has helped millions of needy South Africans.
I kind of got a resurgence in life when I started with the Dis-Chem Foundation. I'd been exposed to so much of excess. And then I actually became exposed to so much of so little. It was not difficult at all for me to actually give that passion and that energy that I used to give to making it happen for these people, to actually making it happen for the, you know, the marginalized, the silenced, the poverty stricken.
What are the learnings you've drawn out of this long, illustrious career of yours?
I think the most important thing is be open, don't be judgmental, try and be flexible. And, you know, along the way, by using those skills, if you can help others and if you can teach others, I think that's most probably the best gift you can ever have in your life.
In an industry where your reputation precedes you, this spin doctor has proven without a doubt that she's indeed worth her salt. Her consistency, humility, and result-oriented approach is what makes her the best in the game. And by extension, this makes her a true mover and shaker.